Adon is an ancient word that means lord. It refers to one singular ruler or person in power. The plural form is Adonai. It's used in the Bible, like in Psalm 110, to refer to a human lord or master. But when the Bible refers to God as the Lord in all caps, it uses an exclusively different form of the word for the God of Israel, Adonai. Moses called God Jehovah until he made him his Lord in Exodus 4. And when he gave into submission, he referred to him as Adonai. Psalm 110 gives us an early glimpse into the Trinity when it says, Jehovah, Naim, Adonai, the Lord says to my Lord, which is the verse that Jesus used to absolutely slice the Pharisees' criticism of him. In Joshua chapter 3, the Ark of the Covenant is called the Ark of the Covenant of Adonai. And Joshua told the people when the priests of Adonai set their feet in the Jordan River, the waters would stop rushing. It was meant to show the people that God would be with Joshua, just like he was with Moses. And Joshua wanted to show the people that God was not just Elohim to him, he was Adonai, he was Lord. The Bible says that when the soles of the feet of the priests of the Ark of Adonai touched the water, it stopped flowing, and when they got to the middle, they were on dry ground. Just like God had been Adonai Lord to Moses, so he would be to Joshua, and David, and Jesus, and us. Just because we've heard these terms a lot doesn't mean that they're all interchangeable. Someone can be God and not your Lord. If you know God exists, great, but making him your Adonai, your Lord, your Master, means something more intimate and more practical in each day of your life. When God is your personal Adonai, you follow his every move because he is your Lord. Through God's names, we learn more about God. My hope, though, is that it wouldn't stop there, that you wouldn't just know more about God, but that you would truly know God.